question. How well our brain is in terms of dealing with liking, wanting, with experiencing pleasure in general. How smart it is. Can we trust? The ultimate goal for us as a social and biological creatures, actually gaining greatest subjective well-being with the lowest cost. And ultimate reward for us as biological creatures actually is pleasure, state of happiness. This state of happiness directly connected with social adaptability, cognitive flexibility, with ability to achieve goals. People with the highest sense of happiness usually have they're more self-confident, they are more efficient, and they're more successful. The opposite side of the pleasure is it can be a reason for multiple psychopathology and mental conditions and even addictive disorder. So the thing is how smart our brain is actually in dealing with pleasure and understanding what it actually needs, likes.
And I love you. God, I love you so much.
Eating your word is actually a multi-steps process. And first step happens in the hippocampus and amygdala. And your brain simply has to understand that something happened. You know, it shouldn't be some stimulus. When amygdala understood, got the signal, you know, something happening. It can be whatever. It can be reaction on some whatever. Light, smell, person, some feeling. It can be just a stimulus. Then, if this process happened in amygdala hippocampus, activation on VTAs happen. VTA, it's ventral tegmental area. Only in this area, release of dopamine happens. But that's not it. This dopamine has to be transferred, it takes time, to a place called nuclear accumbens. And only there, dopamine finds receptors. And when dopamine finds those receptors, actually your brain and your body experiencing the sense of pleasure. But the last step is learning. So your cortex, your prefrontal cortex, to cognitively understand, you know, that this particular stimulus associated with this particular reaction in brain. Mm-hmm. So there is a reward. And after your brain actually learns and associated the stimulus with a reward in your brain, only after this, person or brain understand what it likes, what it not likes, what it wants, cognitively what it doesn't want.
Is that a gram? New card. What do you think?
Whoa, very nice. Look at that.
Picked them up from the printers yesterday.
Good coloring.
That's bone. And the lettering is something called Cillian Braille.
It's very cool, Bateman, but that's nothing. Look at this. That is really nice. Eggshell with Romalian type. What do you think?
Nice.
There is one difficult component. Every step of the process described has explicit and implicit component into it. Some pleasures, for example, first step, when the brain understands the stimulus, it can, or the scientists call it liking. So it's actually the step of getting pleasure when we understand the stimulus and our brain has cognitive association with the getting pleasure, we like the subject matter. But the thing is, we can like it explicitly and implicitly. Explicitly means our brain has clear understanding what particular physical stimulus causes the feeling of happiness. But that can be also implicit component. Sometimes our brain, in a way, don't have clear understanding what exactly we like, what exactly in this particular whatever person, subject matter, causes a pleasure. It's called affective or implicit.
Marla! Maybe we should exchange numbers.
Should we?
We might want to switch nights.
Okay. It's a wanting and desire. Can you believe it or not? But explicit wanting and desire. So when a dopamine releases actually in your brain, we want to desire something. It has a strong associated with the wanting and desire. But the thing is, there is no pleasure. So a person, a brain, doesn't experience any pleasure. There is no ever wanting and desire. It's actually opposite. Wanting and desire are strongly connected to goals, to plan goals. So we experiencing desire. Wanting only in the case that we know that we can get it. Okay, there's strong cognitive network developed in our brain that will drive us to getting pleasure. But here's the thing, it's an explicit part. There is an implicit part of this process. Implicit part absolutely depends on the limbic system. It's only biochemistry of your brain and has nothing to do with your cognitive processes. And I think it's sometimes some chemicals can activate it. Some chemicals. It's why alcohol addiction and drug addiction can happen. And the person will experience a strong wanting, a strong desire without understanding why. Because of simple biochemistry of the brain and mesolimbic system will talk to your brain that this subject will get the pleasure and will be able to provide positive health.
Yes!
The next part is learning. Learning can be implicit and explicit. So learning, what does mean explicit learning? Explicit learning is when our brain understands every single process and can differentiate totally differentiate every single part of it. So your brain knows this particular stimulus associated with this particular hedonic experience or this particular state of happiness. But there is an implicit part of it. Very often your brain does it absolutely unconsciously. So that's why always, you know, classical conditioning always works in advertisement. So certain stimulus which we are not completely understanding, when we're not paying attention, we're not cognitive.
You probably notice, according to neurobiology of the getting pleasure, it's a very long process.
And the entire idea of anticipation of the pleasure, it's a strong feeling. It's a strong feeling, but getting pleasure, it's very short time.
Issues with management, conflicts of interest.
Yeah, well, the boxing world looks shiny from the outside. It's filled with promises that most of them turn out to be lies.
Pleasure, getting pleasure, experience pleasure, the state of happiness. And as we mentioned at the beginning, it's very important. And it's strongly associated with our self-confidence, with our efficiency. Unfortunately, sometimes the path can be broken. And that's happened because of some addiction to particular chemicals or some constant chronic stress. It can happen even during wrong, let's say, when there is some problem during the childhood development. And if some people don't have well-developed, established, you know, healthy biochemistry of rearward beginning, these people have a lot of issues with understanding pleasure, with finding, with figuring, with building a plan of getting pleasure. Those people have serious issues with dealing with their own emotions. So I have to acknowledge
Everything I say and everything I describe in the video, it's not my information. I'm getting all the information from articles I read, from scientific, academic books. And I will post all the links related to a specific subject matter later on my website, 3hbrain.com. Just please remember, I am not author of the investigations, and I'm not author of the results. So everything I do, I read scientific papers and describe them. So please be aware of it.